Hey everybody, happy Sunday to you. I hope you guys are doing great. I just wanted to jump on here really quick and tell you guys that I'm thinking about you this week. Man, it is beautiful in Nashville right now. It is such a beautiful day out here. I got spring fever, I guess. I don't know what else to say. I'm excited. Starting to see shows announced. We definitely have some shows that were on the books from last year that we're hoping to hear announcements about. I know that Rocktimber's coming up, so anybody, if you're catching this later on today or whatever, keep that on your radar. It's in September, and we're looking so forward to it. We're excited about it. It's our first journey up that way, so excited that. It's a bunch of great people on the bill, so... great stuff going on. Rockin' Pod's happening August 7th here in Nashville. I actually saw Chris and Ron on Friday night, got to visit with them. So if you haven't heard about it, check out the Rockin' Pod Expo. It's going to be great artists, podcasters, vendors. It's always a great time. It's a great hang. They go crazy for a whole weekend. I get nuts, take over a hotel. That's a lot of fun. And so that's exciting. Also, in June, it looks like I'm going to do some acoustic stuff. Thank you guys for tuning in on Facebook and stuff. Some people have asked me to, they've seen this online and asked me if I would do some acoustic performances. And so I'm coming down to Texas. Looks like it's going to be in June 19th, I think is the date. I'll keep you guys posted online, pun intended. I'll do some posts to let you guys know. I'm really excited about the show. I can't wait for it to get announced. And hopefully you guys will get a chance to come out if you're down in the Dallas-Fort Worth area. And also something kicking in Chicago in July that's an acoustic thing. So I'm going to be sprinkling in some of those kind of dates with the tourist stuff. We're ready to get ramped back up. We're super excited. Keith's excited. We're trading music. He's actually been sending me a bunch of stuff this week. That we're really excited about. Hey man, I wanted to do a little shout out to John. I think it's John Andrews. He wrote me about this piece of merchandise that I'd never seen before. It was a promotional piece for walking shoes. I'm not sure, I don't think that's Converse, but anyway, I'd never seen this before. He asked me if this was a legit piece, and my wife actually gifted me this. I had shown her the picture. It was really cool. There's a lot of things that are floating around out there that were part of our promotions. We loved our A&M team of people, our promotions people and the record label. They were so much fun, and they kept us so busy on the road. We had a ball with them, and I still stay in touch with a few of those guys. And we just had the most crazy adventures together. It was so funny. And I think about it every time I run across something like this, that we were out there really doing it. And anyway, I want to thank you guys again. Let you know, keep looking, keep watching for this, our Unplugged. We're kind of promoting that right now. And of course, the Bastards of Bill. You can still pick up copies of this. Right Rock Sportswear, Tora Tora. We love those guys. They've taken great care of us. We've had a lot of fun. New merch hopefully coming. And we did get y'all's messages about the the original t-shirt with the bomber girl on it. I know we were out of stock there, so we're going to hopefully have that restocked for you. Exciting. I'm hopeful. Vaccines are rolling out. I hope you guys are doing okay. I hope you're feeling good. We're thinking about all you guys, man. I was thinking about all the things today, man, that I'm just grateful that we're all healthy, and I know everybody's struggling. We went through some financial hardships and health issues and things like that. And if you're there right now, if you're going through something, just know that you got a group of people. We're all on here together, community, culture, family, man, and that... in the music scene that's thinking about you. And y'all be sure and check on each other. That's important. I kind of have been saying that throughout this thing, but it means a lot. messages that you guys are sending. We love hearing from you guys on email and social media messages on our personal messenger. And the interview request and all that kind of stuff, where it's just, we love it. We love talking to you guys. So, I had a friend of mine that was talking about the acoustic Sunday sessions, the sunset sessions. Hopefully they're going to get back outside. I kind of been doing them inside. People are cutting their grass and stuff, so I have to, when I'm doing these, I want you guys to be able to hear without a bunch of stuff going on. But he was asking me about doing a song for him, so I'm going to try to do this one. I don't do this one a lot. I'll try to get through it. This one's going out to Eric, I guess. He was asking about this one. Lonely nights out on the run, and beat the heat of a smoking gun. Blue lights in the mirror as the city sleeps. Brings back a lot of memories. We had such a great time. We recorded that one down in Ardent. Tom DeLuco was a co-writer on it down from Nashville, and he was an amazing guy. He was very patient with us. We were new, and since we didn't have very much experience, we were a little nervous doing co-writes. We were kind of not used to the process, and you know, just being totally honest with y'all, we're a little resistant to it because we were kind of just a garage band. You know, we just kind of we weren't very formal in our training, but we loved the song once we had worked on it, you know, it grew on us after a little while, especially when we heard all the production and everything in the studio. It was pretty wild. It brings back a lot of memories, and the videos. We actually shot two videos to that. I don't know if you guys ever saw it, but we did a we released some of the outtake footage of another video that we shot. It was in an airplane graveyard out in Arizona, and they painted the bomber lady on the side of the airplane, her logo and everything. I was jumping around on top of an airplane. And we ended up reshooting a lot of it in LA at a warehouse. So it was kind of crazy. We kind of went through a lot of production on it and kind of fast-tracked it, revamped it while we were out there. But man, what a ride. That was crazy. Second single and a lot of tour dates during that time promoting it. And so yeah, lots of good memories. I'll tell you guys a couple of things here. Awesome. So I kind of mentioned this a few weeks back. We were working on a song that was inspired by a Janis Joplin documentary called Little Girl Blue. And Keith and I have been working on it, and I thought I'd give you a little preview today. Little girl blue, she came from Texas. Voice, it would shake your soul like a river. She left home in the 1960s. Headed out west to hang with the hippies. Hey, that's barely all. Sing it for me. Big old brother and a holding company. All the way down to the cosmic blues band. The full tilt boogie, we're bringing it on. Little girl, ooh. Oh, yeah. Janis Joplin, man. I'm telling you, that Greatest Hits record, I wore that thing out, man, growing up. She was just so raw and, man, powerful singer. Strong woman in the industry, man, in a male-dominated industry, man. She was rocking the world, man. Pretty crazy. Anyway, we're working this one up for the studio. I thought I'd give you guys a little sneak peek. I've been telling you guys I wanted to share a couple of things with you to see what we've been up to. And, you know, hopefully we're headed in the studio. Keith and I have been getting together, trading out arrangements and everything. And just want to keep you guys in the loop. We have a lot of ballads this time, which is kind of crazy. I mean, I don't know, maybe I'm in mid-tempo slow songs like Melancholy. I don't know if it's just where my mind's at right now or whatever, but so we may have to get you guys to help us. You know, we don't want the project to be too heavy one way or the other, so maybe we'll give you guys some some votes and veto rights or something. We've got a huge stack of songs. That's the great part that we're excited about. But choosing them and picking them, that's always kind of been a wild process, because each one of them is kind of unique, and we all kind of have things invested in them, whether it's riffs or lyrics or melodies or whatever, and then we kind of try to figure out which ones are the best for the project. But we're having a ball. We're having a really good time doing all that kind of stuff. So anyway, maybe you've got time for one more. I know you guys are watching a lot of people streaming. And I was thinking about doing it. I was talking about the Bastards of Ill record earlier. See if I can get through this one. I do this one every once in a while, and I don't play it a lot on the acoustic key. Bye. hope you guys have a great week. Be sure and check on each other, man. Please text your friends and your family. Check on them, man. We're all going through some crazy stuff. And you don't realize how much you might touch somebody's life, man, just reaching out and saying something, encouraging each other. I know it's happened to me over and over, and you guys inspire us all the time. I mean it. I think about the things, you know, you guys think about that, man, the things that make you happy, the things that make you alive. Reach out and tell people about it, and spread it. Spread the love and the hope. You know, we're getting close. We're going to get all back together, and it's going to be amazing. So anyway, listen, you guys take care of yourself. I'll see you back on here, man. Thank y'all for always tuning in. Thank you for your tips. And reach out to us, tortoramusic.com. You can reach us off our website there and on social media. We're always happy to hear from you, man. So I hope you have a great week.